Welcome to Kathy's Garden Corner, where we talk everything gardening. I'm Kathy, and I hope I can provide you with some tips to become a better gardener. Today, we're going to be talking about pests and diseases that I battle in my garden. We'll be right back. Before we get started, I just want to let everyone know that I do not have a sponsor. I'm not affiliated with any companies. I don't get paid to use it to show any particular product. I'm using products that I've used and I'm familiar with and that I like and that work for me. One of my biggest problems, and probably yours too, with gardening is weeds. And honestly, the best way to control weeds is to just get in there and pull them. But if you've got a patch, maybe along a path or in one major area where you have a lot of weeds, the thing that I've found that works really good is dead weed brew. This is by Bonide, and it's called dead weed brew. And it's organic, and I have found it to work very well. You have to use the highest strength. If you get it as a concentrate and mix it up yourself, they give three different levels of mixture that you can use, and I would use the strongest one. That's the most effective. So this is a good one to use. If you're on Facebook or get online, I'm sure seen a lot of different recipes for home remedies that you can use to kill weeds. I've used some of those, the vinegar with water and salt and dish soap, and that works to a certain extent. Again, you'll get down into the weed. It's not a systemic product that will get into the roots of the weed and kill it for good. They will come back. If that's something that you would prefer to do because it's safer, by all means, just get online, look up homemade weed killer, and you'll find hundreds of recipes for different types of weed killer. Another problem that we have in our gardens, and probably all of us have this too, is powdery mildew. I grow wild bergamot, and without fail, every year, my wild bergamot gets powdery mildew. And there are several options for getting rid of powdery mildew. The best one probably is just to cut your, if it's wild bergamot anyway, is to cut your plants down to the ground and let them grow back. But I have a hard time cutting a plant with a flower on it, so I take the more difficult route and try to kill it. And one of the ways you can do that is with a fungicide. This is copper fungicide by Bonide, and it is a spray, and you just spray the tops and undersides of all your leaves, and that should take care of the problem for you, especially if it's not a real bad case. If you've got some leaves, powdery mildew seems to start at the older leaves at the bottom of the plant, and if you can take some of those leaves off, that will give your plant more airflow, which will help keep the powdery mildew down. Then if you spray the copper fungicide or whatever fungicide you decide to use and spray it on the tops and the bottom of the leaves, that should take care of your problem. I also spray it on the ground around the base of the plant because the fungus spores get down in the dirt, and then if you water or it rains, it can splash back up on the plant and you still have a problem. Other plants like tomatoes and peppers and cucumbers, squash is another one that's highly susceptible to powdery mildew. Milk is another thing that you can use to get rid of powdery mildew. If you spray it in the morning when the sun hits the plants, for their sun's rays interact with the milk to kill the fungal spores. I'm not real sure how that works. If you want more information on that, you'll have to Google it. Let's see what else. Baking soda and water, which you would need more water than this, but If you mix up, this is a 1/2 gallon container, and if you mix up 1/2 gallon of water and probably a heaping tablespoon of baking soda, some oil, this is olive oil, you can use vegetable oil or canola oil or any type of food grade oil, and a couple of drops of Dawn dish soap. Just put it into a sprayer and mix that up and spray that on your leaves, and that will help to kill the powdery mildew. I used that last year and it seemed to work pretty well. Again, you have to spray it on the tops and the bottoms of the leaves in order for that to work. There are some other products, like Ortho has a product called Insect, Mite, and Disease 3-in-1. This is used for bugs and diseases, so that's another one that you could use. And neem oil. Now, the thing with neem oil, you want to get 100% cold-pressed neem oil. There's another neem oil out there that's the neem oil extract, and it is not as powerful as the 100% cold-pressed neem oil. And you just mix that in your water and spray that on your plant, and that will kill the fungus as well. There are other fungal issues besides powdery mildew. That's the one that I've had the most experience with, but I am having some problems this year with mosaic virus on my cucumber plant. I'm treating it with the copper fungicide also, so I just wanted to mention that as well. Okay, the third pest or problem that we have are pests, and I don't have a lot of problems with pests. Squash bugs. Squash bugs are one of my biggest pests that I have in my vegetable garden. They can be treated with an insecticidal soap. This one's by Bonide. It is organic. And you can just spray both sides of your leaves and around on the ground, around the plant. It won't harm your vegetables. It will just get rid of those nasty little bugs. It kills the nymphs and the adult bugs. And I did have to use this on my squash plant tonight, so I am using that. And this is another product by Bonide. It's called Insecticidal Super Soap, and I'm not real sure what the difference is. I would imagine that this maybe is a little bit stronger than the other version, but they're both organic, so you could use either one of those. And then I've also used this product. It's by Garden Safe, which is just another insecticidal soap. Now, the other problem I have is with aphids. And with aphids and with the squash bugs, if you can keep check on your squash leaves early in the season and keep a close eye on them, and if you see the eggs underneath the bottom of the leaf, and the eggs look like little teeny tiny copper pearls that just glisten in the sun, they're almost pretty if they weren't so harmful to your plant. And if you take a piece of tape, packing tape, wide packing tape, any kind of heavy duty tape, and just kind of wrap that around your hand and just pat the underside of the leaves, and it'll pick those eggs up, and then you can just throw them away, and then you won't have any squash bugs, because squash bugs live in the ground and overwinter in the ground, and then they come out in the spring and they go up and they lay eggs on your squash plants, and the eggs hatch and the little nymphs come out and run all over your plants and suck all the sap out of the leaves and destroy your plants. When they become adults, they go back down in the ground and the cycle starts all over again. So the key is to get those eggs. If you can get the eggs, you prevent the bugs. I did not do that this year. The thing I have the biggest problem with in my home garden is aphids. And aphids are little tiny soft-bodied insects that suck all the life out of your plant. Get them in the thousands. They just multiply like crazy. I get them on milkweed. A lot of other plants get aphids. A lot of the vegetables even get aphids. A lot of times you can plant a trap, what they call a trap plant, to trap the aphid that likes that. The aphids like some plants more than others, like calendula. They love calendula. And if you plant calendula around your plants that get aphids, hopefully they will go to the calendula and they'll leave the good plants alone. Doesn't always work. One way to get rid of aphids is just to hit them real hard with a hose and just spray them off, and that will get rid of most of them. If that doesn't take care of the problem, again, you can spray them with an insecticidal soap and that will kill them. And if they're really bad, you can just remove the plant or remove the section of the plant that has all the aphids on it. You can also just take your finger, especially if you've got on gloves. I just do it with my bare hands, but then your fingers turn yellow, and just rub them off. Just squish them between your fingers. They squish really easy, and that will get rid of them as well. Aphids do have predators. If you see ladybugs in your garden, let them alone, because they will eat your aphids and get rid of them for you. So ladybugs are your friend. Another bug that pretty widely spread, and we do have them in our area, in our zone 5B, 6A, and that is Japanese beetles. And Japanese beetles will eat anything. They're another bug that overwinters in the ground, in your lawn. If you see grubs in your lawn, most likely they're going to become Japanese beetles someday. One really easy way to get rid of Japanese beetles is to take a cup of water like this, and when you see them on your plant, just take your cup of water over and tap it and let the beetle fall into the water and it'll drown. If you add a few drops of dish soap, that will get rid of them even faster, because then they can't get out of the water. Eliminates them trying to crawl out. Again, insecticidal soaps will take care of them. Neem oil will take care of Japanese beetles and other insects. But the cheapest way is just to walk around your garden with a cup of water, and when you see them, drown them. I like to have references to help me in my garden. And for pests, I have three books that I rely on heavily to know what bugs are in my garden and how to take care of them. The first one is Good Bug, Bad Bug. It's by Jessica Walliser, and I believe this was published in 2011, and this was the second edition, and there's just lots of good information here, and it's real easy. It's nothing real scientific. I mean, it's scientific, but it's not written in a way that it's hard to understand. It's very easy to understand, and there's a lot of good illustrations in it as well. Another book that I bought, and this is the second edition from 2018, it's Garden Insects of North America. This one's by Whitney Cranshaw and David Shetler. And this is a more in-depth book. It really gets into the descriptions of the bugs. There are lots of illustrations, so you can see the bugs at different stages. There's probably not a bug in here that, or a bug on earth that's not in this book. It's just full of helpful information. My favorite pest book is the Vegetable Garden Pest Handbook by Susan Mulvihill. And this is a new book. It just came out this year. We found Susan on YouTube. We watch her YouTube channel all the time. She puts out some really good YouTube videos. Her YouTube channel is Susan's in the Garden. So if you want to check that out, she has some really good videos on how to grow plants and how to take care of them and pests that you might come across. So I highly recommend this book by Susan Mulvihill. And be sure to check out her channel on YouTube. And she also has a page on Facebook. Well, that's it for the pests that I tackle in my garden. I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you would hit the like button, and if you've not already subscribed to our channel, if you would please do that, it will help us out and drive more traffic to our channel. And if you hit the bell, you will get notified when we put up new videos. We'll see you in the next video. Goodbye.